The what is the kind of operand that the instruction can perform? We can divide it roughly into four kind, right? The address, that means we specify the location in the memory to get the value. The number is mean the actual value of the number itself is used. Character is mean that the value interpret as the code of some character. For example, we may use number say 32. I'm not quite sure. 32 maybe represent the space. Okay, when you type space bar, it's actually encoded as the character with the code 32. Or maybe it's logical data. Logical data mostly in high level language is if it false, then it is zero. Okay, if it true, then it is non-zero. The term mean non-zero have several interpretation. Okay. Somebody can take it as if it's false, then it's all the zero, no matter how many bits. Let's use the example with 8-bit. So 8-0 means false. So what is mean true? Anything that is not 8-0. But if you use it as a boolean, then we can say what is the not of false, then it is true. So if you invert the actual bit, all zero become all one. Okay. All one, if you interpret it as two complement number, then it's a minus one. So we have one false, but so many true. Okay. Number can have several formats. Oh, I have to move this again. Right. Okay. The number that store in the memory are limited in the sense that they depend on the how many slots in the memory you are going to use. Okay. And however, today we sort of have some kind of standard. Okay. So if you transfer the number from one computer to another, it's probably remain the same, right? But it's not true throughout the history of building computer. Okay, let's say 50 years ago, if you move the data from one machine to another, you probably have to reformat the data. Otherwise, the number, the value of number will be different. Three type of numerical data are common. One is a binary, okay, and the second is a floating point, and the last one, which is now not being used, I think, it's called decimal. You decimal mean we use a binary to represent the base 10 number. That's explain the last type, the packed decimal. If you want to encode number 0 to number 9, then you need to use 4-bit. However, 4-bit can actually represent 0 to 15, right? But if we want to use decimal, then we use just 0 to 9. And if you have a 32-bit machine, then you can store 8 digits of the decimal. We have a special instruction to deal with this kind of number. The reason for packed decimal is in the old time, the banking business insists that all the small number have to be preserved, right? So because banking very much depend on the trust of their customer. or the customer don't want to lose even one penny, right? So if we use the integer, if the number of slot we assign for that number is too small, then we will lose some number. If we use floating point, which is a real number, then some number always have a small error, okay, because it's a floating point, is the real number that is stored in the computer, is not infinitely precise, okay. So they use a packed decimal. I think it's almost no use today, except some very, very old or legacy software somewhere maybe. To really have the very precise number in terms of data type for modern day, we call big number. Okay, big number is the, you can store integer as an infinite length, depend on how much memory you have. So that that is also available in the language such as Python. So we almost do not use packed decimal anymore. Okay, character as when you want to store a string, okay, you have to represent each character in terms of binary. When you use your computer, you probably, when you store your small text, right, you have to also be mindful about what type of encoding you use. The popular one is for Asian language, the UTF-8. Okay, when you fire up the say Notepad in Windows or Note in Mac OS, you probably have to specify which kind of encoding you use. Okay, for most European language, they use only 8-bit for one character. But for Asian language, we use a 16 and up to 32-bit, especially Chinese character. So when interpreting this kind of string, one has to know what kind of encoding is used. Okay. I already talked about logical data. Oh, by the way, because I use the what they call software to do this video lecture, and maybe it will last for only 40 minutes. So don't worry if the meeting end earlier than you expected. If the time out, I will start a new session. And I have to bother you to, sorry about that, to join in again when the video is cut short, all right? I will broadcast the link to the discussion panel, all right? So give you the actual concrete data type. This is from the Intel x86 family. So it have a integer, it has unpacked binary code decimal, packed binary code decimal. The meeting will end in 10 minutes. All right. Okay. And we have the small pointer, because it's called near pointer, and big pointer. Okay. Small pointer is 16-bit, okay. far pointer is as big as the processor itself. For Intel, it's, I think it's nowadays called 32 or 64-bit. Right? You can specify each bit. You can also represent floating point. Mostly floating point have the standard of IEEE. All right. So each machine can understand that these bit string represent the same number. All right. We will ignore this kind. Just to show you that the size of different type of data is different. For Intel, it also have a special instruction to deal with the multimedia data. Okay. They call MMX or multimedia extension, and this kind of multimedia extension have evolved into extended instruction. For example, advanced encryption standard has been included in instruction in the modern day to provide instruction to deal with security. All right. For AMD, the processor also have a similar data type, right? That's slightly different, right? AMD is different from Intel mostly on that they can specify the ordering of the byte. Okay, we call endian. Okay, if you start the let's see this one. Okay, the ARM register. If you have 4 bytes, each byte say contain 8 bits. So this is actually 32 bits. So if you interpret that the byte zero on the bit zero on the rightmost hand, rightmost digit, okay, and the leftmost digit is the most significant bit. So it's one way to think about it. And you can also think of ordering in the opposite way. Okay, so because in this is very important, because if you store the bit string one way and you interpret it this way, okay, this I think this called big endian, right? And this is called small endian. I think Intel do on the right hand side and everybody else in the world do the left hand side. So ARM decided that to be able to set which kind of data they want to interpret. Okay, this is very very headed. Okay, for low level programming, but for you to who already program in high level, this is already hidden. Okay, so we don't have when we program high level language, we don't have to worry about it at all. But if you program in assembly language, you have to be aware. In our class, we just ignore this topic, but this is very important topic. Okay, for ARM, ARM, you also have various kind. Okay, they have data transfer, arithmetic logic, transfer of control, it mean jump, for example. We haven't seen the actual operation yet, right? We are talking of the set of instruction in general term.